Hey chess lovers, welcome back to the Chessyard. This is dhairyabagga and today I'll be showing you one of the interesting chess games that I just finished playing. Now I was playing here as white and I started off with d4, opponent plays d5. I play bishop to g5. Now bishop g5 after the queen's pawn opening is the Levitsky attack, and it is actually effective because you are preventing the move e6, which is very common when you play the d4 opening. So now opponent cannot play the pawn forward because the pawn is pinned because queen is behind it. So the opponent chooses to go for c5. Here I can trade off, but I thought that I'll just make solid opening here and develop all my pawns in the center. Opponent develops the knight to c6, and I go with pawn to c3. Now bishop now comes on to f5, and here I played my bishop on to b5, hitting the knight, pinning it for now. Opponent has the move queen to b6, but doesn't bother because I can simply take. That would be a check, and then opponent can take with the pawn most likely because opponent wants to pressurize the b2 with the queen, and then that can be saved as well by either placing it forward on to b3, or you can even play queen to c1. Either is fine. So no threats there. On opponent plays h5, trying hoping to trap my bishop by placing pawns forward. Then I go back, and then another pawn forward. I go back again, and then finally my bishop would be trapped. But that can be easily saved because I can place h4. That's what I do here. Opponent plays now f6, trying to kick the bishop backwards. No other option. I have to go on to f4, and here my opponent plays pawn forward c4. Now c4 is bad actually. This can be easily broken from by playing b3 and then a4 eventually. But I don't need to break it right now. What I thought is pressurize the knight further, and I got my queen now on to a4. Opponent saves the removes the pin from the knight by placing the bishop backwards. I took on the knight. Opponent takes back, and now I get my queen on to c3. Now planning to give a check from g6, which would spoil the castling rights for my opponent. Opponent doesn't want that to happen. That doesn't want to allow the queen at least onto g6. So simply places king onto f7. Here I went with a knight f3, trying to develop the pieces. Opponent plays e6. Now if you see the structure right now, computer suggesting that yes, slight advantage to black, 0.1, hardly anything. But look at the board. Do you seriously think that you'll be happy playing as black here or white? You give me this push 100 times, I'll choose white as 100 times, because king is pretty much not safe there at all. Opponent here, white can develop the other knight, castle either side, anything is fine. And these pawns are overextended, can be attacked as well. So I would choose white here for sure. Do let me know what is your take on this position in the comments below. Here I played knight to d2. Opponent places bishop onto d6. Now either I can take or I can just go back and allow the opponent to take, and then my knight goes back, loses the tempo. So I don't want that to happen. So I took it. Opponent takes back. And now I played b3, trying to solve this pawn puzzle here. Opponent goes for b5 and generally meets with a4. Opponent can take and I can take back, not an issue, but opponent plays a6 instead. I take on the pawn. Opponent takes back with the pawn. I took on the rook. Opponent takes back with the bishop. So lots of exchange happen. Opponent takes back with the pawn finally, and that's okay position again, given the situation that opponent's knight and rook are not yet developed, and I can develop in one move by just castling here. I went with queen to a2, trying to give a check from a7 maybe. Opponent plays knight to e7, also defending the bishop. Here I castle. Opponent goes with bishop to c6, preparing to get the rook onto the a8, attacking the queen. And here I played the best move in the situation, which was rook to a1. If rook comes in front, I can simply put my queen on to b2, exchange the rooks, and then take this game from here on. I have a knight pair. Opponent has knight and bishop, and I feel knight pair would be more effective. Opponent plays pawn forward, trying to go for some mysterious pawn trade in the center, which generally you should not when things are like that already. That's a weird move, and it took on. Opponent takes back. Allows knight g5, which is a check. Opponent has to move the king. King comes to g6. Here I give a check with the queen, and opponent has to play pawn forward, not allowing queen to advance further. That is what is played. And here I played rook to a6. I just wanted to pin this bishop here so that it can be used as a deflection later on if required. Also, if you see, my knight is pretty good. If you just move your king somewhere, that can land into a nasty fork. And knight is defended with the pawn. So everything is good on the king side here. Opponent plays knight to f5, trying to take the h4 pawn. And I played g3 here, trying to make sure that it cannot be captured. The opponent sacrifices the knight here. I don't know why. Places the knight onto g3. Maybe the idea was after I take, opponent gets to have the queen here. Give a check, force a repetition maybe, if possible. But that was not possible because the knight was defending. But yes, still, opponent can take the pawn and then the knight eventually. Maybe that was the plan. But it didn't work out because here comes a different move, which he didn't expect. Rook takes bishop. Yep, going to exchange down here because after queen takes, I can take the knight and then there's no queen coming here. Yes, you can get the rook on the open file, but doesn't matter. I have two knights for a rook and I can live with that situation. Extra pawn, yes, but that can be taken away. I have my queen as well. So two knights against a rook and a pawn, I would fancy my chances there. After I took on the bishop with the rook here, my opponent resigns. It was move number 28, I think. Opponent left the game actually after I took on the bishop here with the rook. So yeah, it was a nice game. Ended quickly, I would say. Could have been more competent, but yeah, it was a nice game eventually. Some tactics used, trying to deflect the queen and then trying to take the knight, not rushing into exchanges, because you don't want to fall into any repetition when you are winning or ahead in the game at least. So I hope you like the video. Do let me know your feedback. Keep watching and sharing. Do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already by now. And I shall see you tomorrow with some interesting and instructive content, like always. Thanks for your time. Take care. Bye-bye.